All right, so in this video we will see how to assemble the driver module, and I took here one of the driver modules that already sit with a junction module attached. I'll just remove that so we can have a look at it as it looks without. Now this is the driver module, and it actually comes apart when I take off the junction module, because there's nothing holding them together other than that screw we just saw. Then there's this grub screw or insert screw that has no head, and that's used for the rims or the boundary modules to fit onto right here. Let's see if I have one. So the idea is that these rims sort of attach like this, fit on here, so they are constrained in two dimensions, but I can still lift them down. And then there is a third sort of small fixing module that comes in from the side, like so, and holds it in place with the junction module. Anyhow, let's try and assemble one of these. I've laid out the parts here in order. So from the bottom to the top, we have two ball bearings sitting in this assembly. We have a third ball bearing on the top that just makes sure you can omit this one if you don't want to buy too many ball bearings. But it's nice so that the filament can rotate freely. So the bottom plate is made out of these octagons together with the switching, with the squares from the switching module. And then we have the assembly with the inserts, that is this round two assembly that makes up the rail together with the bottom. And we want to get that concave rail established there. And then we have the ball bearing sitting inside this assembly, sort of shared between these two. And that has a spacer in between, it's the spacer lying here. And then we, through that assembly, we have a M5, about 35 millimeter long, sitting through the whole thing with a few nuts. And I'll show you how to assemble these nuts. And on the top bearing, we have these plastic fittings that can be exchanged to others. So let's try and put this together. I'll start with my M5. I'll just sort of place the first bearing. It should sort of friction fit a little bit inside of here. Put the M5, 35 millimeter long, through there. And then maybe I'll put my bearing, friction fit my bearing inside here first. So it's just sitting there. Don't forget the spacer, because we're going to tighten this all together. My grub screw is already there. Just press it together so they are flat against each other. I'll put my first nut. That's a flange nut, so the flange makes a bit of space. You could use a washer here as well, but the flange is just fewer parts. I'll just tighten this as it is now, and the spacer will prevent the ball bearings from... So it's very loose but very tight fit, at least when we fix these two together. And I'll put my Geneva wheel / gear on top. That should fit over the screw. You see we have the hex cut out there. It does fit over now, and just to tighten it and hold it in place, I'll put another M5 with a flange down, flat, to press that down. I can just tighten this. Now that sits very nicely and can rotate over the bottom. And I'll just have a look. On top of this, I'll put another bearing, and then the flange. This one goes up, actually, to have a flat, round surface on the top, so that things can rotate about there. This one we can tighten a bit, like so. And I'll put this bearing holder, or this one that attached to the bearing, And that would actually be clever to put before, but you can put it after like I just did. And the snap fits, you can put whatever you want. If you need a crocodile nippet there on top, you can use that fitting. So I could exchange this for that fitting. Let's try. So if I have some filament I want to attach with the nippet, crocodile nippet, then I'll just put this guy. Make sure to get the edges over there. And now this rotates independently, like so. You can fix the switching module that will bind, that will tie the whole thing together. Like so. And now these, the top and bottom, are actually fixed together using this M3, and the whole thing becomes more sturdy, rigid, like this. All right, thanks.